morning, everyone. Welcome to online classes of Triveni Memorial Senior Secondary School. Today we will talk about word and inserting graphics in word. In last video we have talked about how we can edit and format a document in word, and we will continue that in word how we can insert graphics also. So basically graphics means when you want to insert pictures or clip art in your document in Word, then how you can insert them so that the document looks more attractive and it can be easily understandable by those who want to see the pictures, then the document becomes more understandable by using these pictures or clip art feature. So when we are talking about pictures and clip art, so what are clip arts? Basically clip arts are the built-in images in your Word which you can use from the program, and then you can insert those pictures. First we will talk about how we can insert the pictures in your document. Now the pictures can be inserted from any of the file. The file would be saved in your computer, or the images can be downloaded from internet and they would be available in your computer. After that you have to click on your insert option. The insert option is available in your toolbar besides the home tab. You just have to click on the insert tab. There you will see the option pictures. You will click over that and then you can browse the location from where you want to insert the pictures. After clicking there, selecting the picture, you just have to click on the insert button and the picture would be inserted in your document at the place where you have selected. After inserting the pictures, now there are two features we have to talk about. First is wrapping text and second is moving an image. Wrapping text means when you have inserted the picture or any of the object in your document, then how you want to place the text near that particular object. So you have to adjust that. So wrapping text is a feature which helps in this. It helps you to adjust the text near the object or the images accordingly. So you will select the image where you want to adjust your text, and after selecting it, there you will see many of the options and you could select that position where you want to place the text. There would be many options. You could see these options and then select the particular option. Second is when you have inserted the picture and the image is not inserted at right place, then how you can move that image from one place to another place in your document. You just have to click over that particular image. The mouse pointer would change to this particular sign. The mouse pointer would change to this sign, and after clicking your mouse pointer over that image, you just have to drag your image to a new location and the image would be moved to a new place. Okay, now you have inserted the picture, you have adjusted the text, and you have also moved the image if it is not placed at your right place. Next is how you can insert the clip art. Now we have inserted the picture from our computer. So there is also an option clip art. This is also available under your insert tab. And in clip art there are built-in images which you can insert in your document. You just have to click on the clip art option available under insert tab. Now a task pane would appear. Clip art task pane would appear. You will enter the keyword because there are multiple images which are stored in your program. You just have to type the category. You can say a keyword you have to type. Suppose you want to search about animals. So you will type the keyword animals, and there in clip art task pane, you will see the images regarding animals. Now the image which you want to insert, select those images or just click over there and the image would be inserted in your document. Next is when you have inserted the images in your document, you can also apply the text effects. Text effect means the word which you have written in your document. You can apply the effects to your words so that they look more beautiful and attractive. So you can use multiple text effects. One is basically available under your home tab. There you will see options like shadow, reflection. You can use that effect also. There is also an alternative option, that is word art, which is available under your insert tab. And in this particular option, There are multiple designs which are available for your text, and there you can select the style which you want to use. Basically, the word art option, this is used sometimes. We want to make our heading look more attractive so that it can be identified easily and it is more attentive. Then you can use the word art option. Already pre-built styles are there. You just have to select a particular style and the word would be available under that style. Next is your bullets or numbering style. Here I will talk about two things. One is your ordered list and second is your unordered list. Now, what is ordered list and unordered list? If I talk about ordered list, when you are writing your text and there are some items which you want to write in some sequence or in numbering form, then the style which you are using for them, that is your ordered list. Suppose I am writing the fruit's name and I am using 1, 2, 3 or the format A, B, C, such type of sequences which are available in your sequential form. When you are numbering your items, that is your ordered list. When I talk about unordered list, it means I am using some symbols to recognize my items. The symbols could be in bullets form. Bullets means the black color circle. They could be any of the pattern. There will be many patterns which are available under it. So when you are using some symbols to recognize your items, then that is your unordered list. So, the item, the text which you have written in your document, when you want to list them in bullets or numbering form, then you can use these options. These options are also available under your home tab. Now, when you have to use them, you just have to select your particular text where you want to use them. And after using them, just select a particular option and there you can see the required format. Next is adding shapes. Now in your document, suppose you want to create any of the geometrical shape or you want to draw something, then you can use this particular option. This option is available under your insert tab. There, when you will select this particular option, adding shapes, the mouse pointer would change to this particular shape. So the mouse pointer would be changed and just you have to select the location where you want to draw the picture and you just have to drag this symbol and the image would be drawn there. So we were talking about text effects. The next effect is drop cap feature. Now what is a drop cap feature? Basically when the paragraph is starting, the first character of the paragraph that would appear in large capital form up to 2 lines or 3 lines. So that feature is your drop cap. Suppose this is your paragraph. Okay, there are 4 lines. The first character of the first word of your paragraph, that would be available in your large capital form. That is your drop cap feature. So how many lines it has to cover, these all options, they are also available under it. So this option is available under your insert tab and there you have to select your drop cap feature and then you can use it. This is also basically used to enhance the appearance of your paragraph. Next is adding a border. Adding a border means when you have created your document and you want to add a border around it or any of the heading you have used, you want to create a border around it, there you can use this particular option. This is available under your home tab. There you have to select the border option and there are option border and shading option is provided. You have to click over there. Multiple options are there. How thick border you want to apply, which color of the border you want to use, you can select that. Then last is when you have created the document, you have inserted the pictures, you have inserted the text effects in your document. Now you want to save your document. Basically when you are saving your file, it's just saved for its future use and the Word file is saved with the extension .docx. The extension helps it recognize that it's a Word file. For saving a document, you have to use File option and there you will have the Save option or Save As when you are saving it for first time. Otherwise, you can also use the shortcut key Ctrl+S to save your document. Next is printing a document you are printing your document to generate a hard copy of it. So if you want to print your document, you just have to click on the file option, and in the backstage view there would be option print. Before finalizing printing your document, you can also click on print preview option. The print preview option helps you to see how your print will look alike, so that if you want to do any changes, you can do it there. Otherwise, you can directly use Control plus P, shortcut key, to print your document, and there you will have a hard copy of your file. So this is all about what we have discussed. If there is any problem, you can contact me, and please share and subscribe.